I'm sorry I'm so grimy looking. I haven't fucking taken a shower today yet. It's,
Linerider. It has to stop, man. It just has to stop. I'll do it. I'll do it if you want me to. If that'll get you to stop PMing me and sending me all the gifts and the requests for the autographs and stuff, I'll do it. I'll send you my underwear, okay? The ones I'm wearing right here in this video, I'll send them to you. All right, fine, and I'll do the interview as well. If it'll make you happy, I'll do the interview. Welcome to my interview, good sir. I have a few questions for you. I was looking at your channel, and at the early stages, I noticed it was all Linerider stuff, as your name implies. Can you kind of explain to me the evolution of your channel? Is what it is now what you had in mind, or are you just fucking around?
Hey, before we start, I just want to say thanks for the interview, man. You know, I only got like 750 subscribers, so like this is huge. I really appreciate the publicity and the recognition, man. I'd love to do the interview. So to answer your first question, you know, yeah, I'd actually started this account started with me being bored in 11th grade computer programming class. I'm just write that shit out, C++, Java, VB, and I'm bored. And then someone pointed out this game, Linerider, and Oliver, stop. Thank you. And at some point I just came Linerider, and I just kind of fucked around with it, figured out how to make the fucking curve with the straight lines, figured out how to do the loops, and I fucking raped the shit out of that game, the original, for a while. And then, you know, the account kind of faded. I made one chlorine bomb video, and that was in, I think, the same year of school. And nothing really happened after that. Senior year of high school went by, graduated. Went into college, and that's when I ran into Venom Fang X's video, Proof That God Exists, or Proof of God. You know, the one where he's giving that dumbass chocolate bar example? That video. And I was intrigued and a little bit disappointed and baffled that so many people were behind him on this and were that easily deceived and twisted and malleable, but only later did I realize that he filters his comments to only approve positive ones. So, you know, that kind of fell by the wayside, and then I found another YouTuber by the name of The Answers of NWO, and surprisingly enough, I didn't think it was possible, but there is someone dumber than Venom Fang X, and it's him. And I got into some heated debates with him, and I over comments, and ousted him constantly. Yeah, that is a spray cleaning product. And I basically just, I didn't really have a choice but to make a video. And then from there, it just kind of skyrocketed and just launched off into what it is today.
All of YouTube land out there wants to know, when I saw this video,
I've ever offended you or hurt you in any way. I want to do better. And I mean that.
What the fuck is that on your neck, dude?
That, sir, was a hickey. You'll see them from time to time in random spots in my videos. They're from my girlfriend, who I rail the fuck out of about 3 to 4 times a day. I am pretty fucking pro at fucking. So that's why that happens. I actually have scars where she just dug her nails into me because it was just so intense on the fireman. That was a horrible porn star name. The fire. I guess I could douse shit with my hose. Let's go with that. Yeah, okay, whatever. You got it.
Have you ever been in a fight? If so, did you win or lose?
I have been in two fights, one of which took place in the Bahamas at a not-so-known location called Orchid Bay. If any of you are familiar with it, awesome, it's near the Abacos. And one night after drinking at the bar, drinking age there was 18, cha-ching! We went out and we met up with some guys and we were walking. And they had pissed off some guys at the previous bar that they were at, in the Marina Resort Bar, actually. And they came at us with some pickaxes, planks of wood, and one dude had a crowbar. And yeah, I did say pickaxe, as in what you mine metals with. Fuck. So we let the guys kind of, I was the friend, actually, we let the most of the other guys take most of the hits and do the beating. We kind of stood to the side and we put in our 2 cents. And other than that, there was one other time, I wouldn't really call it a fight, but what the fuck are you doing? And this dude was hooking up with my ex-girlfriend and showed up at the party that she was at, hooking up with him. Saw him through the doorway, walked in, walked up, said, "Hey," decked the guy in the mouth, put him on the ground, looked at her, said, "Fuck you," walked out.
What are you studying in college?
Currently, I'm majoring in computer engineering at Virginia Tech. I initially started as music, however, music performance. My main instrument is a bassoon. Got in on a scholarship and decided it wasn't for me. So, ditched that, swapped the technology, and that's where I am today.
Do you have a price if I gave you $1 million, would you do unspeakable things to, say, a goat? $10 million? Hell, $10.
$1 million? Terrible, terrible, unforgivable things. I would do terrible, just horrible, unforgivable things to that goat. Oh, man. For $10 million, I would do things to 2 goats. Maybe 10 even. $1 million per goat. Oliver, $10? Nah, you're not really going to get me to do much for $10. My time is worth a little more than that, unfortunately. I'm pretty expensive.
I saw your toe stumping video, and that was pretty gnarly, man. What's the worst injury you've ever had in your life?
The worst injury? Stop attacking me, cat. The worst injury I've ever had in my life, I think... He's the other one. I've actually broken the same toe about 10 times, my left index toe. My door doesn't really open all the way in my old house, my parents' house, actually. And I recently moved out for college, obviously. But that door didn't open all the way, and I really like food. So whenever the intercom went off announcing that there was food ready in the kitchen, I would fucking dip out of that room. And I just smashed my foot on that door countless times, broke it about 10 times. But the worst one ultimately, I have to say, is that right there. That thing on my thumb. Doesn't look pretty bad, actually, when I hold it up to that. But if you look at it, it's pretty gross. It's right on a tendon. And what happened was we had just finished diving out in the Bahamas. And my dad, we keep our dive flag out on top of our outrigger. And we stand it straight up so everybody can see it. And it was raining when we came back to the surface. And... the outrigger was wet, and for some reason, it bends like this, and I decided to hold it like this. So I'm like holding most of the weight with this hand and using no leverage on this one. And because it was wet, this hand, as I was lowering the outrigger, this hand slid right into the ratchet that jointed the thing in place. You know, you loosen it up, you do this, and then you can adjust the level of the outrigger, you screw it back in. And it's locked. And while it was unlocked, this hand slipped into the ratchet. This hand couldn't support the weight. And it just literally sucked my thumb into the ratchet and ripped out that whole side of my thumb. It was pretty awesome. There was actually blood just shooting out of my finger. And I went to the side of the boat to hold my finger over the edge so the blood wouldn't fill up the helm, and the water actually, the blood turned green in the water. It was really weird. I don't know why that happened. But, maybe I'm a fucking freak. Who knows? But yeah, that was really, really bad. See the bone and everything. It was fucking nasty. Other than that, you know, I'm a pretty safe guy. You know, I haven't really sustained a lot of injuries, surprisingly enough, given the amount of dangerous activities I engage in on a regular basis. I drink a lot of milk. That's probably why I don't break many bones besides that one fucking toe. Actually, no bones besides that toe.